If you are someone who tinkers with Arduino boards or similar development boards like this one, chances are you've had to worry about connecting some two projects together wirelessly. In today's video, we will look at how to link these two HM-10 Bluetooth low energy modules together for wireless communication. Come along. Let's quickly look at the pins on the HM-10. This LED blinks at an interval of 500 milliseconds when this is not connected to any other device. Upon establishing a connection, it stops blinking and just stays on. That activity is replicated on this state pin here. So if you have this inside a project in a case and you still want to see the state of your Bluetooth module, you just have to connect an LED through a resistor to this state pin and you'll be able to see that. This VCC pin takes 3.6 to 6 volts, but we'll just connect it to our VCC or 5 volts on our Arduino. The ground here would go to ground, and the TXD pin here would go to our RXD pin, which would be pin 10 on the Arduino. The RXD pin here is not 5 volts tolerant, so we would connect it to pin 11 on the Arduino through a voltage divider network, which is made up of a 1K and a 2.2K resistor. The final pin here, which is BRK, which also stands for break, is used for breaking the connection between this Bluetooth module and any other device it's connected to. So if this Bluetooth module connects to this Bluetooth module or your mobile phone or some other device, and you want to cancel that connection or you want to close the connection, all you need to do is just hold that BRK pin to ground. Let's now go ahead and wire up these Bluetooth modules to the development boards according to the schematics shown. So now that we are done with the wiring, let's go ahead and power up the boards. So when we turn this one on, you can see the LED here blinks just as the HM-10. This is because this LED is connected to the state pin of the HM-10. And now let's turn this one on, and we can see this also blinks as it should, indicating that it is not connected to any device at the moment. Let's now go ahead and fire up our Arduino IDE. So in the Arduino IDE, we'll go up to the file menu, and then we'll go to examples, and then we'll scroll down to serial, software serial, and over here we'll open this example. So this is a piece of code that allows you to use any two pins on your Arduino as RX or TX. In our case, it's pin 10 and pin 11. So we'll leave this as it is. Down here, we will change this to 19200. I found out that the other board rates don't work as well for me. I don't know about you, but I would advise you use 19200. So we change this one here to 9600. This is because the board rate of the HM-10 is 9600 by default. So we need to match that. Everything else in the code can be left as it is. So we'll just go ahead and check to be sure that we are connected and uploading to the right board. So we have an Arduino Uno. The COM port is matched to the correct COM port. And so that is that. So we'll go ahead and upload the code. And so that is also done. So by default, the HM-10 modules are in slave mode. That means that other devices like your phone can connect to them. They can't connect to each other. So what we are trying to do here is change the mode of one of them to master mode, and that would allow it to connect to the other one. And this is something that will happen automatically when we change this to master mode while this is running. It would automatically search for this and connect to it. This is something that only happens with the HM-10 series. This does not happen with the HC05 and 06 Bluetooth modules. So please take note. All right, so let's go ahead and send the AT commands. So for that, we'll have to open up the serial monitor, and then we have to make sure our baud rate here matches what we set in the code, which was 19200. So 19200, and then make sure this is set to both new line and carriage return. And then when you're done, to test whether it works, you type AT. So You press enter. When you get an OK, it means that everything is wired properly and that your board is working well. I would also advise you turn any Bluetooth devices you have available off, especially ones that are Bluetooth low energy enabled. So we will type AT plus row and then 1. So AT plus row 1. After a short time, we can see the master automatically connect to the slave and the light stop blinking. So these two are linked together from here on. And if we power down one of them and we plug back, we can see shortly after it connects back to the other one. So in order to paint a clear picture of the possibilities of connecting two Bluetooth modules together, I decided to advance this circuit a little bit, and this is what I did. So I added an LDR here, which is a light dependent resistor, and that was connected to analog pin A0, and then an LED that was connected to digital pin 2, a tactile push button to digital pin 8, and another LED to digital pin 3. So with each push of this button, this LED toggles its state. So if it was on, it goes off. If it was off, it goes on. This LDR here controls the brightness of this LED. The darker this goes, the more faint this becomes. That was just to show a two-way communication with data going that way and data going back that way. So the code for both boards are as shown here. So you have the HM10BT1, which goes to the master board, and the HM10BT2, which goes to the slave board. Feel free to download this code from my GitHub and make changes as you please, and notice how dim it becomes all of a sudden. And when I take this off, notice how bright it becomes again. So one for on and another for off. One for on and another for off. If you learned something here today, kindly give us a thumbs up to show your support for this channel. If you are new here, subscribe to stay in touch on how to design and build more cool stuff. See you next time.